Welcome back to the channel, guys. Today we're taking a look at Xbox Cloud Gaming here on the Steam Deck. Now, if you follow my channel very much, you know that I do a lot of cloud and local content, and I'm always finding more uses for cloud gaming, even though a lot of my personal gaming is done on local hardware. And here on the Steam Deck, it's no different. I use a lot of cloud gaming on here to both save space, battery life, and so on. But here for Xbox Cloud Gaming, we're able to access a lot of our Xbox games here with Game Pass and streaming that you wouldn't normally be able to access. And I'm going to go in here and we'll take a look at a few games running. But I personally love Game Pass. I love the service. I've loved the improvements to Xbox Cloud Gaming. It still is inconsistent for a lot of people. I know it still needs a lot of work. For me here in my area, since they launched the Series X Blades last year and also have made improvements since then, it's gone from an unplayable service for me to something I can really use on a lot of different devices. And I really get a lot of use out of Xbox Cloud Gaming. So there is on their website, if you don't know how to set up Xbox Cloud Gaming on your Steam Deck, get the assets in there, get your controller working on the Edge browser and all of that, Microsoft actually has all the instructions up, as you can see here, for how to do that. And they even give you all the assets you can download for your picture, where to put those so that your icons show up properly on your Steam Deck and all that. So that was really cool of Microsoft to do. You can get Xbox Cloud Gaming running. I think it took me about 5 minutes. I didn't even have a mouse or a keyboard. I did all on screen and with touchpads. But it took me less than 5 minutes to get that all set up. But anyways, let's go over here and take a look at some games running, starting with Microsoft Flight Simulator. So this is a game that I just find really cool that I'm able to stream and play on my Steam Deck without having to install it or try to run it on the deck or through Windows or anything. I can just straight up stream this on the Edge browser, and I realize it's cloud gaming. Their bitrate isn't the best most of the time, especially for the 1080p. I do want to see improvements to that for a lot of games, but the input latency for me is what's key. So I really have gotten great input latency lately in the past few months with Xbox Cloud Gaming. It's been really good for me. I cannot complain. The stream quality not being too stuttery most of the time, very good. Those are two things for me in cloud gaming I really need to be on point. The third thing is how clean is the stream, the pixelation and the bitrate, and that's something we really want to look nice and crisp and as good as we can. But that input latency and the smoothness of the stream are important first. And on the smaller screen of the Steam Deck at 7 inches, these games actually look really good even with rough bitrate sometimes. As long as you have a decent internet connection, I've been really blown away and I'm really enjoying being able to play a game like Microsoft Flight Simulator here on my Steam Deck. Now, I checked out other games as well, like Gears of War, of course, and Gears 5 streams really well for me on multiple devices, so I wasn't surprised that it did a great job here on Steam Deck. And input latency, yes, it's noticeable and it's cloud and it's not local, but you can adjust to it, and for campaign, it's really not too bad. I wouldn't recommend for competitive multiplayer, but I do know people that use cloud for competitive multiplayer and they adapt to it, and they may not be able to play their best, but they're able to play it. But for me, if it comes to games like Halo, which we'll take a look at as well, or games like this, I'd much rather just try to enjoy my time with streaming with a campaign, that I might not be as concerned if I have hiccups or issues with the input latency. But Gears 5 looks great here. And remember, all these games are streaming the Series X version with their Series X blades or server blades that they have set up for these. So the games look great. They run really well. Gears 5 here can get a 60 FPS. Microsoft Flight Simulator runs at 30 FPS. Of course, it does that locally as well. You have a 1080 60 FPS stream. So on the small screen of the deck, these games actually look really good. I can't really do them justice here on a screen cap and with YouTube, but playing them on the deck feels great. Now, Forza 5 Hot Wheels expansion is another game I've really been loving. I love Forza anyways. I loved Hot Wheels on Forza Horizon 3, but on 5, it's just so much more improved. Now, this game does have worse bitrate issues and pixelation than the others, probably because of the fast motion, and they want you to have good input latency because of the fast driving. And I can say that while the bitrate does kind of suck a lot of the times, I didn't notice as much on the smaller screen, and input latency was great. I had no problem with any racing here, having fun with Forza Horizon 5 streaming, and I do have a great Wi-Fi connection that works well with my Steam Deck. So another great game here from Xbox that I'm able to stream and play right on my deck without taking up any space. Now lastly, we'll take a look at Halo Infinite, another game I wouldn't necessarily recommend multiplayer. I do know people that do it and they're able to pull it off. Personally, for me, I get a bit competitive when it comes to Halo and I want to play at my best, so I'm usually on my PC or my Series X when playing competitive, but if I've got my Steam Deck out with me and I have a decent internet connection and I just want to knock out some campaign, maybe save some Marines, maybe just explore or whatever I want to do, no problem, guys. I can aim, I can get headshots, I can have a decent time, I can lower difficulty if I really need to and I'm just trying to have fun, although I don't find that I would necessarily need to. Campaign is just fine. Again, some people might be all right with multiplayer. For me, I can't necessarily do it. But campaign, I have no problem running around. I'm really enjoying Halo Infinite on my Steam Deck without any installs. And I play the multiplayer locally on my Steam Deck now, which is great since that's been working. Oh, and I love the grapple. Like, who doesn't? Even on the deck here, grapple up, grab this thing, and we're off and running. But anyways, guys, being able to play so many games on the Steam Deck and stream them, I know cloud gaming is not great for everyone, so I can't speak to how your experience will be, but for me, if you watch this channel, you'll know I get a lot of great experiences with cloud gaming for some reason here. I have great input latency, my connections are usually really good, and I'm usually pretty close to data center. So this is all working great for me. I'm loving Xbox cloud gaming on the Steam Deck. Let me know in the comments below if you're playing Xbox cloud gaming on the Steam Deck or if it's working well for you or not. And if you guys haven't already, subscribe, thumbs up, or ring the bell, and I'll see you in the next one.